okay, rumors and news, you in the right place. Want a community that's cool, you in the right space. You want tips, subscribe now and ring the bell. Then go to the park and give them hell. The Boot Squad is an organization with all winners. Soldiers up in formation, we all killers. And when you step on the court, yo, you're our dinner. When I play D in the fourth, yo.
You don't know, it's your boy Brutal Simon the Scene, Wicked and Mean, with a next video for y'all, man. So just take some time out and bless up your boy and like up the video. Definitely help the channel out, man. Y'all been going crazy late, man. I do appreciate y'all. And you know your boy gonna always keep y'all up to date on everything 2K. Now Mike Wynn start tweeting. He start tweeting and answering questions, man. You know, it's about that time. So let's get straight into it. We're not gonna waste no time now. First thing first, this was funny to me. I ain't gonna front. I had to post this one. I could have left this one, but I had to post this one. Right? Now Box asks him, where's the gameplay though? And Mike Wynn say, lots of info will be hitting soon. You know what's funny to me? There's only soon. We only got like 3 weeks, man. Everything is soon, Mike Wynn. Come on, my G, y'all wait last minute and you gonna say it's gonna be releasing soon, info gonna be releasing soon. Yes, we know that there is only soon. That's the only thing that exists. But anyway, let's continue on with the tweet. So Mike Wynn made this post saying, new seasonal animation content drops are for my players only, not for NBA players, right? The goal is to keep the game fresh all year long and encourage players to use signature move that they otherwise may not have. Don't worry, there will still be a ton of variety to choose from at launch. I ain't gonna front with y'all, this doesn't sound too good to me, but let's continue on. And the reason why it doesn't sound good to me, it seems like 2K taking away, then stretching out how they give it to you and act like it's a good thing. Nah, just add some more stuff and then give us the additional stuff along. But let's continue on with the tweets. Now, iMag Xbox, all right, or iMag Gaming, asks Mike Wynn, will you only be able to purchase them during the duration of the season? Now Mike Wynn responds saying, some content will be season exclusives, but the actual on-court gameplay SIGs, shadow moves, will stay in the game once they're dropped. So that means they will be taking away some moves from you? That's what I'm asking. But let's continue on. A lot of people want to ask the questions I'm thinking. Geo asks Mike Wynn, Mike, if I get a good-ass jump shot and you take it away from me in the new season, I won't be happy. Now Mike Wynn responded saying, shots won't be taken away, only added. Alright, fair enough. I could rock with that. Now let's continue on. Black Hand asks him, how has shooting changed exactly this year? Now Mike Wynn responded saying, hard to explain in a tweet. Main change is a much larger weighting towards coverage. Aiming is gone, so no more shot aiming, Zen users. Y'all might have to figure something out. I explain more in our coming courtside reports in a couple of weeks. Shooting is more predictable this year. I'm pretty confident the community will like it. I'll be the judge of that, Mike Wynn. Now let's continue on. Friendly Gecko asks, is Teddy Shooter gone? Mike, please say yes. And he just said yes. So no Teddy Shooter. Well, let's continue with the tweets. Now Ace Ice asks him, can we dribble after a step back using the square again? I mean, wait until the game drop, we're gonna see something like that. But he said no. But you can if you trigger a shot with the pro stick. We gonna always figure out the dribble moves though. That's something I never really care about until we get our hands in the game, because we usually figure out stuff that the devs really don't know. All right, so Tez actually responding to Mike Wynn tweet again, asking, and can you please let us stay 99? I'm gonna stop right there, because that's what he made everyone really concerned about, the fluctuating 99. I don't know who idea it was to put that in the game in the first place. I ain't gonna front with you, Mike. You should have been taking that out. Now he did say you won't lose your 99 this year, so no more fluctuating 99. Now this is big news. It's that simple. This is big news. Now let's continue on with the tweets. Now T-Bone asks Mike Wynn, will animation 6 be limited per position? For example, Will we see Paul Ford Center be able to use Curry's slides and other animations if their playmaking is high? Or will certain animations be locked to certain positions? That is a great question, my G. Mike Wayne responds saying, we're getting more animations based on size and ability this year. Pretty much that sounds like every other 2K that dropped. I created a center that I couldn't use Curry slide on, but I could still dribble like a beast. I ain't gonna front y'all. My center that won the BAM bill was crazy this year on next gen. So it's like nothing changed, to be quite honest. It's just I think the restrictions might be a little bit more strict this time around. So let's continue on with the tweets. Now Stay Dangerous asks him, what's most important when using the controller? Will the muscle memory of dribbling be the same, or will we have to learn how to dribble again? I assume you might have to adjust a little bit, Maggie. But Mike Wayne responds saying, dribbling is probably closer to 20 than 21. Control-wise, example, holding the pro stick always shoots like 20. Okay. Wow. But there are new moves, combos you're going to have to learn. Okay, going back, turning back the hands of time. I see you there, Mike Wayne. A next common 2K trick. Now, I ain't gonna front. This is something I don't really care about because I always learn whatever the game drops, I learn and I try to master. So whatever, it's gonna take me a little while just to learn. It's all right, I'm gonna be labbing either way. Either way, the tutorial is gonna be out there, so make sure to subscribe to the channel, man. I'm gonna make your life easy this year. Trust your boy. Now let's continue on. Now JoJo say, will we still need a high 3-point to shoot because it was hard to shoot with an 80 3-point? I don't think so. But let's continue on. I ain't gonna front. This is a big question because one of the biggest things that set apart 20 from 21 was the ability to shoot with a 70 something once you got the timing of your jump shot. Now Mike Wayne gave some amazing news right here. He said you don't have to be as high as last year to be a perimeter shooting threat if you have good timing at least. So it seems like they're going back with a lot of things similar to 2K20, and in my opinion 2K20 was one of my favorites 2Ks hand down, because that alone gave the game so much flexibility when it comes to you creating builds. Now let's continue on with this tweet. So far he's saying everything that sounds good, but until we get our hands on the game, please don't get carried away. Now let's continue on with the tweet. Now Perp Rain actually responded saying, if you unlock animations at 99, you don't lose them anymore if you drop to 95. Now I'm gonna stop right there because Mike Wayne already said overalls won't drop this year, and this is just the same question that someone asked earlier. He probably didn't see that tweet, so let's continue on. Now JWP asked Mike Wayne, hey Mike, is replay percentage still in the game? He said yes. Very simple, straight to the point. It is. People really shoot out there with replay percentage? I'm really confused. I ain't gonna front. I didn't know people actually did that. Was that, is that a good thing to do? Because if I got a shooter with a 993 and I used replay percentage, technically I shouldn't be missing any wide open shots. I might try that out this year. Now let's go. Nebsfoo, I probably butcher your name, Nebsfoo, tweet at Mike Wayne, I would pay thousands of dollars to know if you remove vibrations from 22 or not. He's asking for the Zen users, clearly. And he said you would pay thousands of dollars. Now, did Mike Wayne cash in this check? This is all I'm asking. And he did say the vibration shot cue is gone. No more shot cue in the game, is gone. I ain't gonna front with y'all. I say that a lot, don't I? But I ain't gonna front with y'all. I didn't care one way or the other, man, but it seemed like people was using it for Zen, so they had to take it out. And unfortunately, with the introduction or with Zen's being exposed, it took away a lot of good things from 2K, because I actually like the vibration, I actually like shot aiming, but unfortunately it would make Zen life so much easier, right? So it's understandable that they removed it. So let's continue on. Joe Ross the fourth Ask Mike Wang, will both next and current gen console receive the new animations N6, or will one get some exclusives in its generation? Mike Wang responded saying the plan is to release the same Sega anime for both, and this is big for me because I will be playing both current and next gen. So I don't want to learn a whole new system and just switch it every time like we had to do this year. It is like two complete different field games. But if you have the same SIGs and the SIGs react the same way, then it will just be a slight adjustment, you know what I mean? Higher frame rate, better quality and stuff like that. And I think the foot planting was something they elaborated on. But let's continue on with the video. Now, what's that? Browdy actually asked him, how different is current from next gen? He said current and next gen are much more similar on court this year compared to last. This is what I'm saying. Okay, so you might not be missing out a whole lot in terms of gameplay this year, but in terms of features and how the game feels, that might be the bigger difference this year. And with this, it seems like current gen might be doing pretty well. And it would be good for someone who's playing both like myself, right? So let's continue with the tweets. Now, this is simple. He already answered yes, but the question was, does no shot meter still give you a boost to your shot percentage in NBA 2K22? It's simple. Yes. So we're going with no shot meter again this year. Now, Twitch Cam K asking, Curry Slide is a seasonal content. LMAO, the whole community, the whole 2K guard community will be in shambles. Now, I disagree. I'm a guard, but I'm dotsing in the building. But anyways, he said maybe I shouldn't release it at all. And he just saying this, you know, Curry Slide is gonna be coming back because Curry actually used this move. It's a common move for Steph Curry, right? Let's call it a spade a spade. So Curry Slides will be coming back in the game, but will they be dropping it for seasonal content? A lot of people just rely on this. Like, we play against people that use like 6 Curry Slides in a row, bro. That's abuse, man. And it's not even effective anyways. That's all the tweets and the updates I got for you all, man. Now, I said before, you know your boy gonna always keep you all up to date on everything 2K. And don't forget, man, go in the comments, let me know what you all think about everything Mike Wang revealed so far. It seemed like they're going back to the NBA 2K20 approach of things. I'm talking about, you don't need a 90-something to shoot consistently. I'm talking about some old dribble six or dribble style coming back. I'm talking about some things that will make the game interesting. And I said it before, NBA 2K20, I had so much fun with that because it had so much flexibility, because you didn't need the highest shooting to shoot consistently. So you was able to create a playmaking slasher and still light it up, and people gonna have to defend you up there. But anyways, just a quick update. Y'all know it is your boy Sim. If you're first time to the channel and you want to be up to date on everything 2K, make sure like the video, share the video, and hit your boy your subscribe. If you're not your first time, like the video, share the video, you never know who's gonna be informed, y'all. Your boy Simon, love, respect, bless up, peace.